Hi, it's Alaska Granny. Today I wanted to talk to you about four emergency food strategies. We know every single day we enjoy eating, we need to eat, and we need to have the ability to continue to make nutritious meals and feed our family. There are four areas of food storage to consider. The first area is the everyday consumable foods, the fresh foods and fruits and vegetables, the meats and cheeses and milk, the things that you buy on a regular basis at the grocery store to make your day-to-day meals. Most of those foods stay fresh for a week, maybe two, but not forever unless we do something else to them, like store them in the freezer. So the foods that you would want every day should be number one. You make sure that you always have enough on your shopping list so that you can make the fresh meals that you want for a week or two at a time. Sometimes we can't get to the store, there's an emergency, the power goes out, there's all kinds of things that can go wrong, including, as we've seen in the last year, this crazy pandemic when we're supposed to stay at home and not even go to the store. So that's when you look at your prepper pantry. The foods that you have for an extended period of time, say 2 to 5 years, packaged goods, open and eat meals, canned goods, and all of the foods that you could use to put together to make interesting meals. Everything from peanut butter, jellies, noodle mixes, there's all the canned foods that you could want. That's where it's nice to have a stockpile in your prepper pantry of foods that can last for perhaps 2 to 5 years. Things like crackers and cereal tend to become stale, so those would be your normal everyday foods that you would have in your regular rotation. So if you wanted foods to last for your prepper pantry, then you have to find a way to either extend the life of those foods or choose options that are already going to last longer. Sometimes just storing foods in a more airtight container can extend their shelf life and help them last longer, but you still should try to rotate those foods before the expiration date, which is not actually expiration, it's a best by sell by use by date when the manufacturer guarantees those foods will still be their best. So the best strategy is to have enough food that say you eat one box of crackers a month, maybe have 2 or 3 or 4 crackers, and then you, as you use one, replace it by another one. As you use two, buy two and replace them until you have an additional amount in your pantry, but not too many that you can't use them before they're no longer tasty or good to eat, because foods do become no longer good to eat. We've all found things in our pantry that were stale, even rancid, or just didn't taste right anymore. We don't want to waste our food dollars storing foods too long so that they're no longer tasty and nutritious. The next area of your food storage is your long-term food storage, the deep storage, the foods that can last nearly forever. A lot of those foods we consider 30-year shelf life, but a lot of them can actually last longer. And those are the dried foods that maybe we put into buckets, rice, beans, oatmeal, grains. Lots of foods can be stored for many, many, many years, decades even, as long as we store them in a cool, dark, dry place. The foods that go into buckets or Mylar bags with oxygen absorbers need to be foods that have a moisture content of less than 10%. So things like dried fruits like raisins and craisins, they have too much moisture in them. You can't use them for long-term, the deepest food storage, but you can put them in an airtight container and have them last for several years. You can't extend indefinitely the life of many foods. So that's where you need to determine how much can you use before it's no longer safe or good to eat, and then how do you keep rotating it so that you still have an additional supply. Now the fourth area of food storage to think about is, what if you really had to evacuate and leave your home? What can you do to have instant type meals in an emergency? Well, there are foods that you should consider for your bug out bag or for a grab and go meal pack. And sometimes that can be as simple as a jar of peanut butter, a box of crackers, some chips and dips, tear open and eat, packets of meat, things like that. But if you really want to set it aside and have it available, full meals that you don't have to worry that you left them in there too long and forgot about them, that's when you want to look at things like MREs, or meals from places like Mountain House that are designed for the long term. They can last up like 30 years. Something to recognize about the MREs is they were never designed to last for 30 years. Yes, you might be able to get a little more out of them if you store them in an ideal situation, but they were never designed for the longest lasting foods in your life. I've made a few videos about way outdated, I think they were 20-year-old MREs that I opened up a few years ago, and they were just horrible. Nothing in them was fit to eat anymore. And I've had people leave comments that they have boxes of MREs, so they're set to go forever. And that is just a foolish mistake. Is this what you want to serve your family in an emergency? You want to have a variety of foods in many different formats, and then you need to always be rotating and checking your food to make sure that it's still safe. Plus, you need to store your food the best way possible. If you store it in your garage, your attic, out in your shed, where the temperature is not controlled and maybe bugs got in it or mice and critters, then your food is not going to last. You need to store it in a cool, dark, dry place. The better you store it, the longer life it will have. If you want to get some of those bug out type meals that you can know that are dehydrated and will last for a long time, you can look for things like the buckets of food from Augustin Farms. They make them with Mountain House, and there are other companies that make them as well. I recommend the ones from Mountain House and Augustin Farms because I buy them and I've tried them and they're delicious. No one can pay me to say these things. This is my own money, my own opinion, and that's what I have. I've tried the Wise Foods, which I think now is called Ready Wise, and I find them to be unpalatable, and I don't recommend them. Before you buy any of these kinds of foods, make sure you get a small amount and you sample it. If you like it, get more. Everybody's taste is different, and so maybe you would like them, but I didn't care for them, and my family didn't either. But they like the Mountain House and they like the Augustin Farms. I've made videos over all three of those companies, opening and eating some of the foods so that you can see what they're like. So you can find more of my videos on my Alaska Granny channel if you're interested in seeing what some of those foods are actually like. To go along with all of your food, you absolutely need water. We need water far more than we need food. We can go several days without water. We can go several weeks without food. Another thing to consider is you can't go forever without sleep. So you need to make sure that you're having an adequate amount of food, that you're getting the proper rest, and part of that comes from having the peace of mind knowing that you're providing the things that you need for yourself and your family. If you're worried that you don't have those things, get a little more. It gives you peace of mind, which can give you better rest, which helps you make the best of every single day that you have in your life. So think about these four areas of food storage. Get some grab and go, open and eat foods for your everyday. Just to make sure, say the power goes out, open some chips and dips, have a little picnic in the house, put together a peanut butter sandwich, open some tuna, spread it over crackers. There are so many easy pouch meals that you're supposed to heat them in the microwave for a minute, but if you don't have power, you could open and eat them anyway because they're completely made up meals. So continue to buy the fresh foods that your family enjoys, make your favorite meals, but then fill in with canned and packaged goods that you could create meals if you couldn't go to the store or you couldn't get the things that you want. Prepping and food storage is lifestyle insurance. It allows us to have the things we count on having on a day-to-day basis so that our lives go as smoothly as possible for as long as possible. If you enjoyed my video, I hope you'll share it with someone else you think might like it. Please subscribe to the Alaska Granny channel.